All right. Did all the believers in the house say amen?
Amen.
Amen again?
Amen.
And amen one more time.
Amen.
Our Old Testament scripture will be, y'all just let me call it what I always call it, Grandmama. This is Grandmama's favorite scripture. We're going to read it aloud from the Old Testament. 23rd division of the Psalms, a Psalm of David. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. Can't nobody do it like him, y'all. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yeah, sometimes I gotta go through some stuff, Grandma say. So yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I got confidence, bruh, that I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Look at what he does for me. Look at what he gives me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. What you got to say, Grandmama? Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of the Lord. How long? Forever.
We have a New Testament scripture. Found in the Gospel of John.
Verse 21, New Testament, John's Gospel. In an hour of grief, two sisters are meeting with Jesus, and the word says that then said Martha unto Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know, I'm hurting right now, but I know that even now, whatsoever thou wilt ask of God, God will give it thee. Jesus said to her, thy brother, he said, Martha, it ain't over yet, thy brother shall rise again. Martha said to him, I know he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. Jesus said to her, I got some good news for you, Martha, even though you got tears in your eyes. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? We have read into your hearings today from the Holy Scripture, Psalms 23, verses 1 through 6, St. John chapter 11, verses 21 through 26. And all the believers in the house said amen.
Amen.
Amen, 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 amen. We're going to have a prayer by Elder Ronald Gates.
First of all, everybody, that you will bow your heads. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, we thank you today. Come to you, Father, looking to you for comfort and strength on this morning. Father, we thank you for the opportunity you've given us to celebrate this wonderful life on today. Father, we thank you for your presence and your power that dwells here on today. God, I pray in the name of Jesus, you will comfort each and every broken heart. In the name of Jesus, God, we thank you, God, for being such a wonderful Savior, for being such a good God. God, we thank you for being here, God, together. I pray in the name of Jesus, God, you will move in this place as never before. God, save me and deliver, save on today, God, in the name of Jesus. God, we honor you, we worship you, we give you the glory, we give you the praise, Father. There is nobody like you, Jesus. Father, comfort this family. God, those who have questions of why, who are searching for answers, Father, I pray that their hearts and their minds will be turned to you as never before, God, in the name of Jesus. God, we honor you, we thank you, and we accept what you have allowed on today. We give you praise and glory. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Everybody say amen. Also here to do a solo this morning. Then he asked me to do this song, said this is one of the songs she wanted. If you knew it, sing, clap, we're going to celebrate her life this morning. Amen. Walk with me, Lord. Walk with me. Walk with me.
Yeah. We got to have a home going. Because ain't no doubt about where grandmama is. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. No, she went too hard. She helped too many people. For us to sit down and act like it's all over, we're going to see her again on the other side. Somebody else, I know you got it all right. I'm good. God is good, ain't he? Yeah. Just point your elbow at somebody and say, the Lord is good. The Lord is good. The Lord is good. You know what? I got tears in my eyes. Yeah. Thank the Lord. All right, we're going to act right. Amen. See, grandmama didn't need a lot. Can I tell you this? She didn't need a lot to know how to have church. She called me long distance and said, don't you see the preacher on the phone on TV preaching? She gonna tell me, she gonna ask me two things. She, what did you preach this morning at your church? And then when I tell her what I preach, she gonna tell me whatever preacher in Atlanta on TV will preach today. She gonna tell me everyone. Amen. So she knew how to have a relationship with the Lord. Amen. Don't you rub your elbow, your neighbor, and tell them, say, you need a relationship with the Lord. That's the only thing that's going to get you through. I'm going to tell you right now, you can do all that other stuff, but when you get through with it, you still got to deal with some stuff. So you want to need a relationship. Yeah. I'll be out of your hair in a minute. I'll be on the plane going back soon, but I'm here today. All right, we've got a poem by her grandson, Sean Copeland.
Hello. The name of the poem I wrote is called Change. As I woke up this morning, I kind of felt a little strange. I had to check myself as I called out her name. There was no answer. There was no reply.
My God.
I looked at God and asked him why. Change is what he said. Child, stop looking back. Look ahead. She's in good hands now, in the hands of the Almighty. Her love is yours forever. She's no longer in the body. As she waited for her day, and that day finally came, as she looked to the sky, God called out her name. Now come with me, child. I have some work for you to do. There's a garden here in heaven just waiting on you. Remember that these are your flowers, and they are still in need of your care. They were often looked to the sky, just to see if you're still there. But being the master gardener you are, you will still know just what to say, because every flower still needs a blessing to help it through this day. So every second, every minute, every hour, let every flower in here, let it be known that our Queen Helen Reed Gresham has finally made it home.
My God.
I love you, bro. God is good, y'all. Yeah, this is tough. You can talk to grandma on day, noon, or night. Every time something happened in Texas, it's a big state, you know. Y'all all right down there? I saw it on the news. It looked like your truck going in the water. Nah, grandma, that wet my truck.
And she's going to tell me about Sean and Pop and Drew and Dee Dee. She's going to give me all the 411. Yeah. So when you see us crying, it's crying, it's tears, it's joy. Yeah, we got something to celebrate. Because she leaves a legacy. What's a legacy, Pastor Dyson? Those are the things that live on after you are gone. See, some of us, our whole life is about me, myself, and I. My brother Joe, he's four and no more. Come on, you're going to get that one on your way home. But sometime in life, you got to reach a point where you live for people. And life goes on beyond you. And so when you heard her talking about the family, she wasn't gossiping, she was proud. Oh my God. Yeah, what a beautiful poem. Thank you, Sean. Thank you, thank you. All right, the family, we're going to have remarks at this time, and the family has requested that we keep these remarks to 3 minutes, please. 3 minutes, please. So at this time, if you have remarks, you can line up right here by this first pew. We social distancing, so let me help you. Got one? Do we have any more? Come on. So get in line. Do your 6 feet. Amen. Amen. All right. At this time, we're going to have our remarks.
Rest in peace, Grandma.
Don't forget to tell my dad. Don't forget to tell my dad that the game misses him. And give Dad a big kiss.
I just want to thank
my
give your name. Go ahead, my brother. We will give your name all the praise. Come on, somebody, give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Follow the program. We are up to the obituary being read silently. Amen. Slideshow will be. Running at the same time.
So you clean me. Thank you.
my job too today. Let me do part of my job. I need you to know, in case you're here, in case you're just one of those people that you really don't know, if I don't say nothing else, I need you to know she's not here.
Yeah.
I need you to know this is where she used to live. Just the other day, she transitioned. She's in a new place. She's with other loved ones. Matter of fact, the line on that side, as we get older, we start to realize the line on that side is getting longer than the line on this side. And that just means that we're getting closer to being, it's being our turn. There's a day and an hour that we all got to go this way. So we just came to say bye. We just came to celebrate. But we know that to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Grandma's with the Lord now. She's with the Lord, y'all. She's with the Lord. And I got some news for you. She loves every last one of you, but if she could, she wouldn't come back from over there. She's what Hebrews 12 and 1 says. She's a part of a great cloud of witnesses. And now she's looking back on this side. And now she's looking back. And she said, run, Pop. She said to her children and her grandchildren, run your race, baby. Grandma better finish hers. I need you to know that. I need you to know that. We honor her today by coming together. The feeling of a queen she was, putting away in this way, saying bye like this, but she's not there. The song says she moved from her old house, and she moved into a new house just the other day. All right, we're going to move on, but I just want you to know, because the Bible says we grieve. We don't grieve, because it's natural to grieve, but we don't grieve as those who have no hope. All right. We're going to have a poem now from Sister Landers. It's coming.
Good morning, y'all. Glory be to God. I'm going to read a poem to you by Ronald Tramer called The Broken Chain. We little know that day God was going to call your name. In life, we loved you dearly. In death, we do the same. It broke our hearts to lose you. You did not go alone. For part of us went with you the day God called you home. You left us beautiful memories. Your love is still our guide. And although we cannot see you, you are always on our side, at our side. Our family chain is broken and nothing seems the same. But as God calls us one by one, the chain will link.
All right. All right, I want to shift gears for just a moment and say just a word. There are times when people come in these moments, just let me walk through this. I've been doing this since I was 13, so I take liberties where I believe it's appropriate to do so. Let me say to you, some people come and they preach a sermon, and typically they preach a sermon because they don't know the person that was here. The word eulogy, U-E-U, means good. The last part of the word, ology, eulogy, means a good word. Typically, when you preach a eulogy or say a eulogy, it's because the person has a relationship. They know something about this person. I'm here on assignment today. I was humbled a few weeks ago when we sat with Grandmama. And we were planning this day. And I was just kind of being supportive and letting her grandchildren have their conversation with their grandmama. And grandmama looks at me and said, well, and she looked back over, son, I guess he gonna do it. He know me. And me and Sean looked at each other and said, okay, that's the way she wants it. And I honor this family for carrying out her wishes, doing things the way she want them done. There's a word in the book of Proverbs, chapter 31, befitting of, y'all let me refer to her the way she is today, of Queen Helen. Proverbs chapter 31, verse 10, one verse, I'm not going to be long, but I want to make a couple of points. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. I want to talk for just a few moments about lessons from Queen Helen. Lessons from Queen Helen. Lessons from Grandma. You know, this is an interesting scripture, because when we look at this scripture, many people have looked at this scripture, and it's a scripture that talks about the ideal woman. But one of the challenges with this scripture is the word virtuous. When we look at the word virtuous, we talk about moral character. We talk about what a good person the person is. But when the writer wrote this, the meaning of the word virtuous was different then. Men would go away to war and stay gone for years and come back. And they had to have women who, while they were absent, could keep the family together, could still keep the family together, could handle the chores, handle the livestock, and handle the children, and handle all of this stuff. So it was a word that really meant one who was strong woman, a keep it together woman, a warrior woman who wouldn't let things fall apart, who wouldn't give up, who wouldn't quit, who was resilient. I'm talking about Queen Helen. You ain't picked it up yet. Took everything that life had to throw at her and was just had so much class. Y'all know, y'all know grandma had class. She just had class. Just the way she carried herself. I never saw grandmama out of character. It might have been a couple times some of y'all got on her nerve, but she always kept it at a certain level. She always believed the best. She always wanted the best. And every time, I don't know how she did it, but she lived her life showing up for y'all's special moments. I know when we had our child, she's 25 years ago, when we had our child and we were going through it, and my wife had lost her mother, and the only thing she wanted in that moment was her mama to be there. And we were living in the East End, and guess who got off the train? Welcome to Northern Virginia and Washington, D.C. Here come Grandma. And Grandma gets off the train, and Grandma is there when we come from the hospital, and Grandma was there to show her granddaughter how to be a mother. She did. I want to give you three things if I can. If I can give you three things that you can't question Queen Helen, you can't question Grandma about. The first thing is she taught this family that family comes first no matter what. I mean, every time, even members of the family, I mean,
mean? I mean, when Dee, I hadn't even met Dee. When Dee got married, Grandma must have called and talked about it for 3 months. She wants you to know what went down at the wedding. She wants you to know what a good time it was, right? She has story for every one of y'all. Why? Because family always came first. I know what you're dealing with today. I just went through this. I've been in this seat. Not for preaching for 40 years. Not for that. I'm talking about in my own family. I've had to sit in the, matter of fact, just January, when I preached my own mother's funeral, the first voice I heard on the other end of a phone call was Grandma. Tell me how Robert doing. Let me talk to her. Family. Everybody say it with me out loud. Just say family first.
Family first.
No matter what.
No matter what.
That means that you're not going to always like what each other do. You're not going to always like what each other say. I remember some years ago, Blue got in some trouble. And Blue got in some trouble, and Blue was in trouble, but when Grandma called me, Grandma was getting down, Blue, she didn't talk. Robert, I said, are you, same question every time somebody in the family going through, are you praying? Yeah, Grandma, I'm praying. Come on, let's have prayer. She want to know if you're praying. She didn't call you to talk nothing bad about him. She want to know if you're praying for the family, because it didn't matter whose fault it was, for Grandmama, family was always first. I know you got your mask on and you're hurting, but you need to say it with me. Family first. Second thing we learned from Queen Helen, we learned from Grandma, is Grandma never missed an occasion to have a family fellowship. We call it a church fellowship. Y'all just, we just call it just get together. Always amazed that even when we came the time before the time, Grandma was always in the kitchen. Same question. We done drove 800 and some miles, and we just glad to be here. And the first thing she asked Tammy, you call Sean? Pop said they coming later on. So and so said they coming. We looking for him. Go chase him down. Sean said he'll call me. Whatever it was, it was always about what fellowship the family coming together. And if it meant the oldest person in the family had to cook the food in order to get everybody together, then she was going to cook the food. And everybody else bring what they bring and throw in. Somebody say fellowship. So in other words, Grandmama say always put family first and always take the occasions to come together and celebrate who you are. Because she just done showed you how to do it. She done showed you how to do it. Just what was it? Several years ago when she got her diagnosis. She was still up, moving around, doing what she did, and she just kept running her race. So Grandmama showed us, she showed us, when you were around us, how to take a punch. That in this family, we don't quit. In this family, you don't throw in the towel. In this family, you don't give up. In this family, you don't just walk away and run. In this family, you keep on fighting. And you always put each other first, and you always come together and celebrate. Come on, somebody say fellowship.
Fellowship.
Yeah. I know sometimes, let me talk to you, because when it ain't amen, it's amen. It hurt me, it hurt. That means you got some issues. You got some unresolved issues. But all that stuff ain't important. That's what Grandmama taught. That ain't important. What's important is coming together. Coming together, celebrate. Don't miss the moment. Don't miss what this thing is all about. Matter of fact, we ain't gonna have it. A lot of folks singing that song right now. I wish I had more time. How you know that? Because in January, that was my words to Grandma. I said, Grandma, I was just with her on Monday. I thought I had more time. Robert
it's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. She encouraging the preacher. It's going to be all right. She ain't got to suffer no more. So the same words her mama told me about my mama, I'm now telling you, she don't have to suffer no more. So lessons from a queen, lesson from a queen, the first thing is family first, no matter what. Second, always, always enjoy the Kodak moments. Always enjoy the fellowship. Because you just don't know when it's going to be the last time. Life is too short to be tripping on stuff that really don't matter. Matter of fact, won't you rub somebody's elbow and say, we got to let the silly stuff go. Got to let the silly stuff go. Got to let the silly stuff go. Life is just too short. But if she told us about family first, I mean, if she tells us about fellowship, but she tells us how to fight. Because I have not seen many people stronger than grandma. Let me let y'all hear something. Grandma was in pain. Yeah, dude, she had been hurting for a while. I didn't cry till Tanner saw her cry. Said, I ain't never seen my grandma cry. So while you over here with you, she fought and she hung on and she fought a good fight. She kept the faith. She did what the scriptures say. She kept a Bible in her hand. I can tell y'all something about Bible. You know, she had a scripture for everything, right? She had a scripture. And for all of y'all who owe you owe her money, she told me what your name is and how much money you owe her. She kept the books. She kept the books for her. She kept the books on all of y'all. All y'all, right? And now you might have gave her a check and she never cashed it, but that wasn't the principle. The principle was, did she pay your debt? Mama, no, you know. Grandma, what I know. You know the Bible say pay your debtors. Now, after she said that scripture, pay your debts, then she's going to use that as her number for the day. God don't play that number on pay your debts. Somebody hit numbers all the time. I said, now, Grandmama, I know you studied the Bible. I'm studying, Mama. I'm studying. But are you studying the Bible to study the Bible? You study the Bible to get your number for the day. She was in the Word. She was in the Word. And she just enjoyed that. That was her, just her hobby. Amen. Amen. That and going to the casino with her family, those were her great memories. She was a fighter, y'all.
Yes.
She was a fighter. She didn't give up. She didn't quit. Pain will make you quit. Pain will make you throw in the towel. I've seen pain bring grown men to their knees. Pain will do something to you. Pain is an educator. Pain will teach you some lessons. Yeah. Pain will humiliate you and bring you to your knees. Pain will put water in your eyes. Yeah, yeah. Pain will keep you up at night. Pain will do some things. I saw grandmama on the block. I saw grandmama put her hands in the Lord's hand. I'm gonna get the woman out of here right now. I saw her put her hand in the Lord's hand. And I saw her say, I'm gonna hold her on and see what the end's gonna be. I saw grandmama say, this earth is not my home. Lord, we celebrate the life, the legacy of Queen Helen Gresham. Lord, she's with you now. Lord, now be with this family. I know you're taking care of Grandma. You got her in your hands. She's in union with her family now. But down here, we're hurting. It feels like the glue of the family is gone. But Lord, I know this woman. Lord, I know that her desire was that they were pulled together. So right now, some kind of way, touch hearts. Bring this family together. Let them do it for Grandmama if they won't do it for themselves. Let them love each other the way she loved each of them. God, you move now and heal hearts. Give peace to troubled minds. In the precious and powerful and mighty name of Jesus, do we pray. Every believer in the house, say amen. Say amen. Say amen again. Oh yeah, we're going to make it here. We're going to make it here. In a minute. We're about ready to go. Amen, amen. Just a verse. I know I cut it short so I can be quick. Help me down through the years. The Lord's been good to me.
Thank you. Yeah.